Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part 8 of Absolute Value Inequalities, and we're going to solve the following inequalities on this video. These are the tricky ones. So here's a problem. 5 minus the absolute value of x is less than 1. All right, so we want to isolate the absolute value sign, right? So how about if I subtract 5 from both sides? There's more than one way to do this, by the way. I'm just going to do it this way. So what do you have left on this side? Be careful. You've got a minus sign in front of the absolute value of x. So that gives me on the right-hand side 1 minus 5, or 1 plus negative 5 is negative 4. Now, you still haven't isolated the absolute value. You have a minus sign in front of it. So what you could do is multiply or divide both sides by negative 1 to get rid of it. So let's say I think of that as a negative 1, okay? I'm going to divide both sides by a negative 1. And what happens when you divide an inequality by a negative number? That's going to switch to greater than. So what I have left on this side is absolute value of x, but this becomes greater than. And then what's negative 4 divided by negative 1? Positive 4. All right, that's one way you could isolate it. Somebody else might do it this way, by the way. 5 minus absolute value of x is less than 1. They say, ah, I don't want to have a minus in front of the absolute value. Okay, so I'm going to put the add that absolute value of x to both sides of the equation. That way, it is on the right-hand side, but at least it's positive. So on the left-hand side, all I have is a 5, let's see, less than, I just need to give myself room, 1 plus absolute value of x. Be careful, all these ones and absolute value, they kind of look the same. So then I've got to still isolate the absolute value by doing what? Subtracting 1 from both sides. So I get 4 is less than the absolute value of x. Now, you're used to seeing the absolute value of x on the left-hand side so that you realize it's a greater than problem, but these really mean the same thing. So if 4 is less than absolute value of x, then absolute value of x is bigger than 4. And then these were the easy problems we did at the very beginning of solving absolute value greater of x, just bigger than a number. Either you're going to say x is less than negative 4 or x is greater than positive 4. That's how we get the x out of the absolute value sign and solve the inequality. So the answer here is the negative infinity to negative 4. It's strictly less than, so we'll have to use a parentheses, union, 4 to infinity. The tricky part about this problem was the minus sign in front of the absolute value. Next tricky problem. Absolute value of 3x plus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. Any ideas here? Well, all absolute values are greater than or equal to 0 because it's a distance, so it can't be less than 0 ever. So you know what this one is? There's infinitely many solutions. It's all real numbers. Everything works. It doesn't matter what ends up inside the absolute value. It doesn't matter what you put in for x. When you actually take the absolute value of it, you certainly are going to get either 0 or a number bigger than 0. So this is all real numbers. So don't waste your time solving it. Think. What does that mean? Absolute value, it's saying the distance of something is bigger than or equal to 0. It's like, yes, got it. All real numbers will work. Now you could generalize it and say, all right, anytime I've got, some junk in the absolute value and it's greater than or equal to 0, I'm just going to say all real numbers. Okay. You could memorize that. I don't memorize it. I just use my brain each time and reason it out, and I come up with the answers. So if you've got like a 0, think about it. Think about what's going on. Next one. Absolute value of 4x minus 5 plus 4 is greater than 4. Okay, so we want to isolate the absolute value. Let's subtract 4 from both sides, which gives you the absolute value of 4x minus 5 is greater than 0. Okay. This is really similar to the previous problem. Is there anything that's going to make this one untrue? So you have to think about this. What's the difference? It doesn't have the equal sign. But we know the distance is always going to be greater than or equal to 0, right? But this says just greater than 0. So the only time this won't be true is if what's in the absolute value actually equals 0. All right, so let's just see what that would be. What's inside the absolute value? 4x minus 5. So 4x equals 5, and if we divide both sides by 4, let's see, I'm going to make all of this a little bit smaller so we can get all this on one page. Divide both sides by 4. X is 5/4. Right, now notice I wrote 4x minus 5 equals 0. Actually, the answer to this problem is everything except that number. So it's every single number except 5/4. Because what would happen if you put in 5/4 for x? Look at this original problem. Or actually, look one step down, actually. If you put in 5/4, you'd have the absolute value of 0. But the absolute value of a 0 is 0, and 0 is not bigger than 0, so this is a problem. So there's one problem when x is 5/4. Every other number will give you something so that when you take the absolute value, you'll get something bigger than 0. So if I were going to look at the number line here, it's every number except that. It's hard to write that in the interval notation. I'm going to put a circle instead. So here's the solution. Everything except 5/4. How do you write that in interval notation? Well, it's negative infinity up to 5/4, but not touching it, union 5/4 all the way up to infinity. So that's the solution in interval notation to this original problem up here. So it's a tricky one. If it was greater than or equal to 0, we'd get it to say, oh, all real numbers. But this is all real numbers except 5/4. It's the only time that'll make that 0. Now, these are tricky problems on this video. You might want to, think about these a little bit longer. Watch this video more than once. Kind of, use your noodle. Try to make sense of it. Okay, here's the next one. Absolute value of 2x plus 7 is greater than or equal to negative 2. All right, just think about that. What do you think the solution is to this problem? This is really similar to one of the other problems we did. What do you know about absolute value? It's always greater than or equal to 0, so it's certainly always going to be greater than or equal to negative 2. So no matter how you look at this problem, what's it going to be? Doesn't matter what you put in for x, once you take the absolute value of whatever this stuff is, it will all automatically be already bigger than negative 2. So the solution is all real numbers again. If you want to see it on a number line, here's negative 2 and there's 2, you just, it's like everything. Everything works. It's kind of cool. So you could generalize these, but I don't think it's that important to generalize because I think it's better to think about the problem each time. You don't want to memorize everything. It's too much. All you really need to know is what does absolute value stand for? Distance from zero on the number line. That's key. As a little review, can you remember what this is? What if it was 2x plus 7 was less than or equal to negative 2? Remember the solution to this one? Okay, again, think. Absolute value of 2x plus 7 is less than or equal to negative 2. That's the one there's no solution because we know this is going to be bigger than or equal to zero. It's impossible. So this is going to be no solution. So it's going to be the null set. Okay, I've given you a lot to think about. We've done a lot of videos on absolute value. Now you got to mix them all up. So sometimes you'll have a less than, sometimes you'll have a greater than. You have to know what do you do when you have a less than, what do you do when you have a greater than. All right, so let's just finish up with the basic guidelines. So here's the summary. If k is greater than zero, then to solve something like some stuff, absolute value of stuff is less than or equal to k, you're going to solve this equation. Negative k is less than or equal to the stuff is less than or equal to k. So you're taking the stuff out of the absolute value. And the picture usually looks something like this, right? It's in between two numbers. Now, if it was strictly less than, you'd use parentheses, right? Instead of the brackets. So if we have k is greater than zero, then to solve, the absolute value of some junk greater than k, then you solve this compound inequality. You take the junk is less than negative k or that junk, right? I'm taking this stuff out of the absolute value. Don't write the absolute value sign. This is how to get it out of the absolute value sign. Or the junk is greater than k. And usually the picture looks like this, where they're both going away. And there's some numbers in between that are not the solution. And if it was greater than or equal, then of course you would have the brackets here. All right. And so there you go. Lots of problems to work on. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.